I've been memorizing scripture for years now, and during that time, I've come across a number of free tools that, frankly, I wish I'd known about earlier. So if I was to start over, what would I recommend to somebody who wants to memorize the Bible faster and easier? I know a lot of people who love to review the scripture. They've memorized using physical note cards instead of an app on their phone. And I love this as well, but creating those cards tends to take up a lot of time, doesn't it? Well, there are plenty of places online where you can buy sets of cards for memory verse review, but did you know that there's a place to create your own for free? Using this verse card maker site I found, you can input the passage you're memorizing, how many verses you want per card, and the size of the font. With the click of a button, you can easily print this as a double-sided page, and within minutes, you have cards to review. The only downside to this tool is that you're limited to the ESV and King James Version, so if you memorize something else, you're kind of out of luck there. If you've learned the first letter method of review, which I've talked about in the past, it's a way in which you give your brain only part of the information that it needs to recall something that you've memorized, I have another free tool that you're gonna love. The Memory Grid Maker from Scripture Memory Fellowship allows you to pick a passage of the Bible that you're memorizing. Let's say I'm going through John chapter 2 right now. I can choose the translation and then create a printout that has the first letters of each word laid out in a beautiful grid. If you've never tried this method before, it's really worth a try. I've even created a t-shirt. This shirt is a conversation starter and a reminder to me of 2 Timothy 3:16 through 17. You can find links to both that free grid tool and this t-shirt below. Last week, one of our community patrons named Rachel was getting a little burned out with the rote memory of the Psalms she was going through, so she decided to give music a try. She found the book of James put to music by one of the people that I've interviewed before and put it on repeat throughout the day. To her surprise, the speed at which she was able to capture all 5 chapters of James using only songs that she listened to was just incredible. There are so many great music resources that I can't even list them all here, but I recommend searching YouTube for the passage and translation that you're memorizing and see what's available. There's great stuff from Seeds Family Worship, from Shane and Shane, from Bible Song, and so many others. I'm a big fan of using my phone to record myself saying the verses or passage that I've memorized so that I can listen to it while I'm running, walking, or just driving my car. Now, that by itself is a free resource, to be sure, but the biggest downside is that once you listen through, you have to restart the file to listen to it again. And that's where my friend Craig Brown, who I interviewed last year, told me about this non-traditional app to help out. It's called Jam Looper, and the app is normally used by musicians to loop a section of music over and over again and just jam over it. Except instead of music, Craig would record the verses he wanted to memorize and then have just them listened to on a loop. This app is free and available on iOS and Android, and so it's a great way to review on the go. This kind of free resource video wouldn't be complete without mention of mobile apps like the Bible Memory app or Verse Locker. There are others out there as well that do pretty much the same thing, helping you memorize scripture. The benefit of these apps is the ability to remind you what you need to review and to space out that review in a way that will help you move these things from short-term to long-term memory. The downside that I've noticed is that using these apps means that you're constantly looking down at your phone, which I'm really not a big fan of doing. If possible, I encourage you to move away from tying your scripture memory to your phone. But if you enjoy using these apps occasionally to keep track of your review, I completely understand. Okay, I know this last one is a bit biased, but I don't think there's any better way to build excitement and accountability around your scripture memorization than by doing it in community with other believers. If you can find a friend or somebody at your church to do this with you, that's ideal. In person is always better. But for many of us, that might be hard to do, and that's where our free online Bible memory community can be so helpful. As an example, just last week, we completed a 7-day summer challenge where our community members set their own goals and encouraged each other to work at these goals on a daily basis. In just 1 week, there were hundreds of new verses that were memorized, and people who'd lost a little bit of motivation were able to get excited about committing more scripture to memory. If you want to join us, visit BibleMemoryGoal.com/join to become a member. I would love to see you there. What other resources do you think are missing on this list? Leave a comment with your own ideas and be sure to find links to everything mentioned in the description. And if you want to understand the 5 most important habits to memorize the Bible faster and easier, then you can watch this video next.